I might not have selected mechs that are fast enough to capture this.
Acknowledged.
Oh, we got it. Oh no, don't destroy it. Okay, whatever. Oh, there's a jump jet guy, eh? But we just- Oh god, we one-shotted him!
Oh god, we one-shotted him!
Alright, we're off to a great start here. Welcome back to another episode in our very special MechCommander playthrough. I'm your host, Gaming Jay, and if you're just joining us, in the last two episodes, we played through the first and the second operations of the Inner Sphere invasion of Port Arthur. So this campaign takes place in over a number of different operations, and each operation has about six different missions. So we have established a beachhead, we've gone through and raided supply lines and attacked bases, and when we left off, we were just getting started on our next major operation. So without further ado, let's return to the game and see where we are. So we have Operation Vanguard, let's learn what that's all about.
Incoming transmission.
Zulu Company has successfully crippled the Jaguar supply line. However, Yankee Company was overwhelmed by Clan Elite and suffered brutal losses. While Yankee rebuilds, I'm diverting Zulu to take out several targets west of Affendale. Do this quickly, and you will be able to advance on the city itself. Zulu Company. The Clan will not expect so bold a thrust, but maintain momentum and you'll have the advantage of surprise. Understand this. Once you begin the push, you must capture the city. If you fail, we can't get you out. Remember, you'll be liberating Affendale, so collateral damage will be unacceptable. Battalion is working to meet demands, but losses have been high. Pay close attention to your loadouts and watch your salvage.
All right, always good advice. Pay close attention to your loadouts and watch your salvage. So we are going to be liberating a city. I think we are up to the task. Escort two of the ambulances to the extraction point. Escort five to the extraction point. So this is another low tonnage mission. Man, I thought we were done with these. I kind of retired all of our light mechs and kind of sold a bunch of them. But I think I kept Cougars, so we might have to do a few of those. So if we can take four mechs, 50 tons, that's like 35 tons per mech. So let's see what we got going on here. So we do have 1, 2, 3 Cougars and a Raven. That's not super exciting. Is there anything more fun that we could do here? We'll bring a Hollander into the mix. Hollanders move at 24. I might actually purchase a Hollander, a one-time buy for this. I think at the end of the last video, I sold some Hollanders. Oops. Oh well, I feel like typically the way this game goes is it moves you towards progressively sort of more heavier hitting missions, so you need bigger and bigger mechs. So I've been slowly phasing out all my light mechs. Didn't realize we were going to be going back in time for this one. Someone had told me, maybe I wouldn't have sold all the light mechs. Anyway, Cougar, the Cougars are coming back for one more night on the bar, or one more night in the club. Our cougar ladies here, they're coming out looking for hot clan studs, and they're gonna take them to Funky Town. And by Funky Town, I mean they're gonna fire many PPCs into their face and obliterate them. So first and foremost, we always go looking for PPCs, none for sale. That's okay. Go ahead and buy some long-range missiles. So we're going to basically strip our existing mechs for parts, and we will throw these parts back onto our existing mechs as we need them. So we're basically at a point in the campaign where I think we're... Oh, this is about the halfway point, and we're hitting a point where basically we almost have enough good weapons and stuff that we don't need to constantly cycle stuff off of our mechs, but we still don't have quite enough of the equipment that we want in order to fully load out, like, what do we have, like, six medium and heavy mechs? Then we also want to, like, now just randomly load up three Cougars. So we're actually maintaining a pretty large force, all things considered, with our supply lines the way they are. We have seven PPCs to go around. I'm gonna divvy this out here. Let me just see real quick here. Let me pull my mech warriors.
This is
off
Hitman.
Of these mechs
this is Hunter.
Here.
This is Link.
Grab four dudes, or three dudes, I guess is all I need, whatever. I'm gonna quickly throw Link. These guys into the coons here.
This is Hitman.
And I just wanna like check my weight. If I throw in Cougar 1, Cougar 2, and Cougar 3, I have 45 tons left to play with, which means we can buy that Hollander, a Hollander you guys were eyeing. So we can have the armor variant, which has moderate armor. We can have the weapons variant, which has light armor, or the jump variant, which I don't think is what we're going to go for. I say let's go with the armor variant. I don't know. Actually, I'm kind of tempted to maybe go for the weapon variant. Let's do it. Let's live dangerously. Why not? You know, we're a reckless outfit, I tell you. We're going to strip all this garbage off of it. Does not need a Gauss rifle. Instead, it needs PPCs. More PPCs. And we'll throw some LRM racks on it too. One, two, there we go. Two PPCs and two clan LRM racks. That is a good mech. And we need someone a little more skilled than those bozos to pilot it. So how about we grab the beast. The beast is going into action in the Hollander. All right, now we just need to finish equipping our Koogs. Let's make sure that they have some basic sensors. I don't want to put... So clan sensors are a little better than the Inner Sphere variant. I don't want to throw those on the Cougars. Just because these are light mechs, they could easily be destroyed, and then we'd lose a valued piece of technology. All right, so we're going to throw some LRM racks on here. Guy can take a bit more weight. There we go. Okay, that weighted him down. And we'll just throw these on. Boom. All right. So every mech has two PPCs except this one. And this one has more LRM racks than these. Nice mix of PPCs and LRMs, though. Actually, you know what? I'm going to dump... I want some clan ER lasers. I am going to... Let's see. How do I want to do this? I feel like this guy should have a laser or two. How about two? There we go. And then maybe... Can we throw a clan LRM rack on? How's this going to work? He just has, like, almost enough space to make something interesting happen. And this guy needs clan LRM racks. This guy also does, too. Alright, well, I feel like that's okay. One to two to three LRM racks per character. Oh, he just has so much dense space. Alright, whatever. Alright, that's pretty good. It'll be fine. Let's go ahead and throw these guys into action. Hunter, Lynx, Hitman, and the Beast. They're all going out for a night on the town. Pick up some college studs. After severe Jaguar counterattack, perishable medical supplies, blah, blah, blah. A clan vulture is mounting primarily long-range missiles, has been reported. Guess what? I specialize in long-range combat. You want to have a long-range mech? Because I will take that to task. Now, these guys, can I control them? I cannot. All right, so they're probably going to go of their own accord. So I just sort of have to keep an eye on them. The first matter is to find a hill that we can climb up so that we can get some nice vantage points. There's a jump jet guy, eh? But we just... Oh, God, we one-shotted him. All right, we're off to a great start here. So if you've watched the other videos, you know that my strategy is primarily to mount long-range weapons and just basically try to obliterate dudes in one shot. It's one of the best strategies in the game. We just obliterated a bunch of mechs. Wow, this guy actually took damage. Look, this, which guy is it? Lynx here. Took a bit of damage to his torso there. He got sloppy. I would love to have a bit of jump capability on these guys, but sadly, I don't have any jump capable cougars. Uh-oh, new contact. But, I'm on it, sir. There we go. We'll have these guys just casually take out these tanks. These guys know what they're doing. The trick is going to be to make sure no one sneaks up behind the medical dudes. Because if anyone came up behind right now, I'd have to, like, rush back. So part of the reason that I just wanted to take four light mechs rather than just like one or two heavy mechs is I want the maneuverability. I definitely want the speed here so that I can run away from the, oh, hello. Hold on. We're totally just gonna airstrike those things. Those are aerospace spotters. They will artillery us, so we're going to hoist them with their own petard and just airstrike them. Forget about that. Those are one of the few vehicles or enemies in the game that can actually give me some trouble. Because I feel like airstrikes do so much damage. Okay, actually, we're going to send Hunter down here. He is going to rush down here and capture this headquarters. While everyone else just sort of stays up here. I don't want to get too far away from the ambulances. If we capture this headquarters, it should reveal to us where all the enemies are. There we go. All right. So this is showing us. Ooh, there's some supplies we could try to capture. I guess we'll see how close we get to that. I don't want to risk, getting too far away from the actual mission that we're supposed to be accomplishing. We're being trusted with a great important mission here, which is escorting these, oh, look at that, that's totally a trap. Boom, get out of here. And that's a trap too, I can see it. We have a great mission escorting these ambulances, so I don't want anyone sneaking up on us. Oh, another one, eh? I'm on it, sir. I feel like we definitely have a chance of running out of missiles on this level here. I'm trying to watch my missile fire too. There's only so much you can do. You can't tell your guys not to fire missiles, unfortunately. It'd be nice if you could, if you were like, if there was a command you could issue and you were like, stay light on ammo usage. Get rid of the map there. Ooh, resources. It's always good to check out all the buildings you can whenever you find a random deserted town, in case there's a warehouse of resources just hanging around. Alright, we seem to be getting close-ish to these Oolers down here. No, I wonder if we could airstrike them and kind of like lure them up. Let's see.
I have a new contact on my screen.
The best use for the airstrike I can figure out. And actually, let's use a drone here. Ah, there we go.
I've got a new sensor trait. Yes, sir.
Okay. Everyone just attack that guy real quick. Destroy him. Boom.
Hunter here. Have a new contact.
Okay. Oh, it actually did obliterate those guys. Alright. You know, we can just run down. We can just send one dude, like, run him down, and we can, capture those supplies. Oh no, wait, they didn't get obliterated, they're right here. Okay, let's just ice them real quick. Oh man, they go down so fast. Awesome. Boom, kaboom. Boom. I'm gonna send Hunter real quickly to run down there. And Hunter, you're actually gonna become a second group. You're gonna go back to group one. So I'm separating out the groups so that oh wait, what is happening here? Oh shit. Am I getting attacked? Oh, those guys are attacking. What the heck?
No problem, sir.
Little guys are attacking right over here. I was like, somebody is firing. What is happening? No, stay away from the APC.
No problem,
oh good, he's trying to attack me. Oh, there we go. That guy just went. That guy didn't do anything. Okay, F2, capture. Boom. Now get back up here. Lickety split. You can be the commander again. Alright, we're doing pretty good. We haven't been separating people from the ambulances. These ambulances are no rush. They're like, we're just gonna casually drive. We're gonna go the speed limit. We don't wanna get in any trouble. Casually go the limit. There's no rush here or anything like that. I think we're doing pretty good on ammo too. Actually, I take that back. We're probably close to running out.
I have a new sensor trace.
Let's see what we got here. It is an armored car. And Two armored cars, all right.
Yes, sir.
While they are engaging, let's really quickly check our payloads here. 16 rounds, but he's probably pretty indicative of everyone. They don't make it easy in this game to like rapidly check how all your dudes are doing ammo-wise. Like, it's a little cumbersome. Hey, there's that vulture. Kaboom! There's the heavy mech. One ERPPC. Damn it. They didn't even let us... We killed the vulture so fast and so hard, we didn't even get to salvage anything from him. That was the mech that we were specifically warned about in the briefing. They were like, hey, watch out for the vulture. There's a vulture around here, and he's not messing around. And you see how fast that guy went down? He's not even salvageable. He's just gone. He's literally obliterated. He was waiting here all day in the hot sun. He's like, here come those inner sphere scumbags. Here we go. Prepare to die, free birth scum. And he powers up his mech. And he's like, ah, four light mechs, here we go. And then just like a blast of like six PPCs hit him right in the face. LRMs flying at him. He's like, dear God, what's happening? He didn't think light mechs could pack that much punch, but let me tell you, they can. Those are our missile turrets. That's our turret control. Can we capture components from our own base? How awesome would that be? Kind of wonder what's like over here. We'll scout it out. I think these things are in total safety at the moment. If not, my mechs are nice and speedy. The Cougars know how to get around town nice and fast. So, is there anything cool over here? I see cement! And there's nothing. There's absolutely nothing. I guess it wouldn't make much sense to capture supplies from your own base, but... I still would do it if I could. Man, these ambulances are in no rush. No rush at all. So, like, most of the map is unexplored. I wonder, like, are there extra components I could salvage over here or something like that? Can I just airstrike a random part of the map? I cannot. So you can only airstrike parts of the map that you can see. So, like, we could call an airstrike there if we want. Obliterate that pond. If we wanted to. Kaboom! That was a total waste of military resources. We could get court-martialed for that. But we also don't care. I think we're doing so good in the clan wars that the chiefs at, you know, the powers that be are just going to let us get away with whatever we want at this point. As long as we keep winning battles, ain't nobody going to court-martial us. What? These guys are going off the road. What's happening? We have off-road ambulances. God, they're slow. Mission they're so slow. Mission all successful. Right, there we go. That was the whole mission. Welcome to mission number one of the third operation of the war. We killed two enemy pilots. I'm pretty sure it was the Cougar and the Vulture, the ones that went down. That Cougar that tried to sneak up from behind us, he definitely got killed. And that Vulture definitely also got killed. All right, crappy salvage. An ERPPC actually isn't that good if you take a look at it. So normal PPCs have a medium range. I guess I don't have any there. You can see in the bottom left, the medium range, 7.5 damage, 7.5 seconds recycle time. The ERPPCs have the exact same stats. They have a longer range, but they take an extra 3 sort of loadout weight. So that's basically an LRM rack. I'm not a huge fan of the ERPPCs. I basically feel like at medium range, they're long range weapons enough. Although maybe like an LRM rack is only one damage. Maybe I should. Maybe it is worth, you know, using them. I don't know. Anyway, first things first, let's look at our mission to figure out what kind of mech loadout we need. So we have 300 tons. Destroy two industrial complexes. Destroy Major Petrov's unit and destroy the primary turret power. So 1 and 3. Okay. And this says basically... We have a Bondsman Major Petrov's command unit was heavily damaged, blah, blah, blah. So damage, Petrov's unit should not be underestimated. Heavy and assault mechs have been reported. All right, so we might see some heavier mechs, which would be exciting, meaning we should probably take the heavies ourselves. So what I'm thinking is we definitely want to bring in the Hunchbacks. And it might just make sense to bring the Atlas, too, and have that be that. So let's go ahead and do our loadouts here. So there is no fast way to unequip stuff, unfortunately. But there's one mech. 2 mechs, getting our PPCs back, and 3 mechs. And we definitely want these clan long-range missile launchers. Off you go. Actually, let's check purchasing real quick. Check for some components. Can we buy a PPC? We can buy one. I will take it. Also, in terms of mechs that we can purchase, still can't buy an awesome. Awesomes come with 3 PPCs, which is pretty sweet, actually. 3 ER PPCs, in fact. Which I just said I should give more of a shot, so I don't know. And this guy definitely doesn't need anything as well. Hollander is going into storage. I guess we'll keep it in case we ever need a fast, small unit again.
This is Scarab.
I'm going to take these guys out of the pilot seat. And let's go ahead and equip these babies back up with their... We now have 8 PPCs, so we're getting into, like, a good territory. It's good to be able to have, like, 2 to 3 PPCs on every mech, I find. Go ahead and take off that large laser. And this guy also needs 1 PPC. He's a Gauss, rifle. We give him a PPC instead and an ER. And let's do this. And that. Wait, yeah, okay. There's a good mix. 5 long-range missiles, PPC, and ER large laser. I wonder if I can do that with basically everyone. Like, just give them all the exact same loadout. Would I have 2 of these? Then 3 of these? Alright, so that's pretty good. The Hunchback Ws. And we have the armored variants, which can take a little less. So, I think they just end up having... 2 less LRMs. There we go. Alright, so that's a pretty good loadout for the Hunchbacks. And... okay, I am going to retire these Centurions because we just don't have the space for them at the moment. So off you go. This guy was loaded up with all sorts of sweet stuff. Clan long-range missile launchers, PPCs, LRM racks. Okay, off you go. And we go in here. I think, oh man, we could make one hell of an Atlas. Like, this thing could be legit terrifying here. I'm even gonna strip the PPCs off of my catapult. And I'm straight up gonna put my catapult in the storage too for the time being. So for the Atlas, what have we got to work with? Thing's gonna be a PPC boat. Oh god. 4 PPCs, 2 ER, 3 ER lasers, and then a bunch of missile launchers. Hold on, we can take off one of these, put on one of those. You know what? Never mind. Take this off, put this back on, take this off. Just put on normal LRMs. Boom. He only has 2 LRMs, but you get into medium range. 4 PPCs and 3 lasers. That he will literally one-shot most mechs. So who is our most efficient pilot? I think it's Hunter. Hunter's getting the big boy. So the Atlas is basically going to be Captain Death. He's going to be running around obliterating everything on the battlefield. And these guys are already like veterans and stuff. So,
this is Link.
Like, it's okay have a couple of these guys
this is Hitman.
In these mechs, but I kind of want to, like, level up some of my other pilots. I'm going to give some of these other guys a chance. So, like, for instance, oh man, we have some green mech warriors. We probably should just
Falcon
get rid of them.
Here.
Falcon and Beast is actually quite good in terms of gunnery.
This is Scarab.
We're going to let Scarab in the pilot seat. It's almost worthwhile to have, like, some throwaway mechs that you just, sort of, like, throw random pilots into, just to have them in the battle, just to get random experience, but... Anyway, Hunter is such a beast that he's literally by himself, and everyone else is the backup squad. This is the main force, Force Group 1. You know what's weird? I just noticed they don't call them lances. In the Battletech universe, a unit of mechs, of 4 mechs in the Inner Sphere, is called a Lance of Mechs. Calling it Force Group 1. It's quite odd. Anyway, we have to basically crush everyone. So let's do it. Oh man, Captain Death. Is that what I called him? the Punisher, or I don't know, just whatever. You know what? He goes by many names. He is the merchant of your demise. That is his name. You see this thing on a battlefield, you run the other way. Unless you want to get one-shotted. Alright, so we have to destroy turret power and industrial complexes. Easy enough to do. Basically, we just need to destroy everything on the battlefield. I think we're going to be just... I think we've put together precisely the correct crew to do this. Let us see what we got going on over here. Oh, hello. I'm just gonna take out this look, see, he spots for aerospace strikes that are actually really hard to dodge. So down he goes. And we're gonna run these guys over this way. Look, they're busy fighting this drone. That mobile headquarters is like, run! Run!
I'm under attack.
Look at this thing! Okay, can we capture this guy? I might not have selected mechs that are fast enough to capture this.
Very good, sir. Acknowledged.
Oh, we got it. Oh no, don't destroy it. Okay, whatever. We captured him and then obliterated him so that he would never tell our tales. Dead men tell no tales. Oh, that is a mech repair bay. That's actually pretty good to know that exists. So we might blow our way through this wall, capture that, kill these guys, capture some of this stuff, formulate a nice little battle plan over here. Meantime, let us capture these resources.
Acknowledged.
Enemy components. Report.
Looks like only one of these is up for capture. What did we get? Anything cool? Two large lasers. Meh. Alright, let's carry on our plan here. Rush over this way. What are we destroying? Industrial complexes, I think it was, right? There are the two industrial complexes. So we'll take care of these in short order. Now that I know, because my Atlas has very few missiles, I can use it to destroy buildings and stuff, because he's not really going to waste much ammo, because he really doesn't have much to begin with. So I can use my hunchbacks to basically, be the missile boats of the battlefield. Okay. We have nothing going on. Alright, carry on then. It's like right in that forest right there is where we gotta go. Hidden in this forest are industrial complexes, apparently. It would be really fun if this game had no drop limits, but it would also be ridiculously easy. So like they gotta put some limit on what you can field in the battlefield. But imagine if I came in this battle just 8 like decked out atlases. The enemy would have literally no chance. It's an interesting sort of mechanic to try and make you like evaluate what you want to bring into the battlefield, you know? Like how many mechs and how much power do you want and everything. What did I miss something here? I have to somehow get in the forest. Okay, I'm gonna deal with that in a little bit. Why don't I just go invade this base? You know, since we're here, let's do a little light base invasion. So I actually want to be kind of like over here. We're going to run across the battlefield here. I wonder if after I take this base, if the assault mechs or whatever are going to show up to try and like wrestle the base, you know, from my control, which is not going to happen. But yeah, this battlefield feels very empty. There's not too many opposing forces here. Alright, Hunter, your job is to blast a hole through this wall, and then the rest of us are going to run on through. So, you go for it. Let's see him in action, this beast.
I'm taking fire.
Meanwhile, they'll offer some covering fire. Boom, boom.
I'm on it, sir.
Okay, he's not as impressive as I was hoping, but whatever. He's gonna get the job done.
Very good, sir.
Meanwhile,
wait here. That takes care of him.
Everybody run on in.
Fire.
And kill this.
Scare him here.
Boom. Oh, he one-shotted that Uller.
One less enemy.
That's awesome.
Fair price for everyone.
Okay. Guys run in here. So we are slow. I am noticing the slow speed here. But we'll go ahead and one-shot that guy too. Damn. Okay, we have these turrets under our control, but they seem to still be firing on us. Kill that. Boom. I'm not too worried about taking damage here, because we're literally just going to heal in a second. Oh, there's two mech repair bays. Jeez. This base actually is very well stocked. Very well stocked. Okay, you capture this. You capture this. Capture this. Stop destroying the turrets. They're about to be ours. All right. Now we can actually get our guys to get repaired. So what happens in the repair bay? In fact, I'll go to the data and you can see, is they get their ammo replenished. Yeah, there it is. So you can not only repair armor damage, you can also go ahead and have them, like, you know, replenish ammo and stuff. So repair bays are pretty big deals in these maps. You can also get mobile repair vehicles and bring them into the combat if you wanted. But I feel like there's not too much point.
You got it.
Because we're definitely not struggling with defeating our enemies. It's just sort of wasted tonnage to bring them in. But, I mean, you could do it in theory.
No problem, sir.
All right.
No problem, sir.
And you do not need a repair.
Repair complete.
Great. Oh, he wanted to be repaired from this bay. He ran all the way over here. All right, so we need to destroy the primary turret power. Oh, wait. Wait. We have to destroy the turret power? But we just captured all these turrets. Oh, my God. What a waste. Also, this is a secondary turret power. Okay, well, whatever.
I'm on it, sir.
Let's go ahead and do it.
So much for that.
Let's go ahead and capture the sensor control. Wait, what is it directing us to here? Oh, these are the industrial complexes that we're supposed to destroy. You know what? If I had left that secondary turret power powered up, the turrets would have worked for us. I guess the primary power is way over here, hidden somewhere. Like, seriously, where is it?
Yeah. Target
hard to see. Alright. There we go.
Target eliminated.
So there's that. Ooh, here come some enemies. Okay, you know what? We don't need turrets. We'll fight them in a one-on-one fight. We're straight up gonna fight these guys honorably. We don't need no stinking turrets. You think you're bringing enough assault class? Oh, he's got five mechs. Okay. We'll still win. You know what? We'll still win. I was gonna say, you think you're bringing enough firepower to take me on? I actually think that you are delusional. I'm even coming out of the base to engage you. I could have hid behind my walls. I could have waited, but no, I'm doing this the honorable way. We're even gonna run out here so we can scout this little terrain that you'll be walking on very soon. Okay, that's pretty good. So it'll be, these guys are going to be in like a choke point. They're going into the kill zone. Where are they? Oh, they're way far down, actually. Wait, where are they? Oh my God, they're so slow. All right, we'll just take our time. We'll wait. We'll wait. We can evaluate our units while we wait. 1, 2, 3, 4 PPCs, 3 ER lasers. That's 15, 30. That's like 34 damage in one volley. Pretty much enough to single shot anything. I wish you could actually see how much armor your guys have. Like, they have armor, but it's, you don't get to see actual numbers, so you can't really run the calculations yourself. Everything is sort of hidden. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Here comes the money. I'm into range, suckas. Ooh, a jump capable Jaeger mech. Let's engage this guy at medium range. Kabam! There goes that guy. Kabam! Oh, that guy's piloting an awesome. Good for him. Alright. There he goes down.
I'm on it, sir.
I like how you can knock enemy mechs down on the ground. It's like so humiliating. They're like taking so much damage that I like, can't even get up.
I'm on it, sir.
Hey, you know what? We didn't destroy the primary power yet, only the secondary, so those guys, the turrets are actually fighting them. Pretty cool. I don't know why those guys ran in the base. Like, what were they trying to prove that they could? They were like, we're totally gonna die here, but we just wanted to prove that we could run into the base if we were so inclined. I guess we missed destroying the primary turret power, so. I didn't know that was a secondary objective. I would have done it, but whatever. Cost me like 6,000 gold or something. Oh, we got an awesome! And some ER PPCs. That is better. So this game is all about salvage. You definitely want to get as much salvage as you can. ER PPCs are going into the bank. You can take these lasers off. I will repair this awesome because it's awesome. I don't know if I'm going to keep it or not, but I will repair it. This thing is junk. So we'll definitely sell that. Jaeger mechs. Do we want Jaeger mechs? Can't tell. They are jump capable, so that's actually interesting. It is nice to have sort of some jump capable mechs. I think we're going to sell this one, though. So purchasing. Get rid of this guy. And we're also going to dump this guy. We don't need too many more light mechs hanging around. All right, two missions down. Mission number three, we need to capture 4 supply trucks or capture all supply trucks. Oh god, spies tell us the Jaguars are moving 7 trucks. So we actually want fast mechs again. 300 ton limit. They keep teasing us. They keep saying like, nah, you're not ready for the heavy mechs yet. You're not ready for the heavy mechs. So we definitely don't want to bring an Atlas into this battle, so. Looks like the party's over. Let's take all the PPCs off of this thing. Put them on light mechs. Is there anything cool we can buy? We can not buy any PPCs. I keep buying them out of PPCs. We're also at a point where I don't think we need any more long-range missile launchers, but I just like to have an abundance of them hanging around. Could get an ER PPC, but I'm still just not 100% convinced. I guess we'll buy it anyway. Who cares? What am I here looking for? Wanted to see what's for sale. We still can't buy an awesome, even though we salvaged one. Okay, so 300. So if we did 30, 60, 90, 120, 30, 60, 90, 120, we could do like 30. So yeah, we kind of want a bunch of light mechs again. Well, it keeps pulling us back in. All right, bringing the Cougars out of retirement yet again. I wish I could buy an extra Cougar. I don't like only having 3. I want 4. And we have 3 Uhlers. I'm actually going full light on this one, surprisingly enough. All right, let me equip these bad boys. All righty, we have an Uhler with a PPC and an ER laser, one with just a PPC, one with just a PPC. They're all loaded with missiles. Then we have our Cougs, who are actually light on missiles this time around, but they have double PPC loadouts. And this one also has a large laser, so I feel like that should be kind of a good mix. I think we're still actually below our weight tonnage, but let me throw some pilots in this, and
this
we'll see how it all shakes out.
Falcon here.
Okay, we're like 100 tons below, so we can throw in a handful of more mechs. Problem is I want fast mechs. Maybe we go with Commando J's. Alright, we got PPC and LRM each. And these mechs are going to pack a punch. We're gonna have to do some reorganizing. This guy's jump capable, and so are these guys. So I'm gonna have like a little jump crew. We're still like 50 tons below. You know what, let's bring the Raven out of mothballs. And give it some actual good weaponry here. So, like every mech in my crew, you get it. Well, we just barely have enough PPCs to give every mech a PPC. Maybe we'll give you an ER laser, too. 3 ER. Okay, so this is sort of a defensive Raven. No missiles on it. And I think what I'll do is get one of these green dudes.
Hawk reporting.
Yes,
throw
sir.
Them into it, and we'll put one of the good guys in this commando. Wow, we're using up literally all the mech warriors we have. Wonder if there's any like good guys to hire down here. Outlaw is actually not too bad.
You got it, sir.
Hire this guy. Maybe I should throw him in instead of one of these guys. Yeah, I don't know. I think maybe it's fine as is. Oh no, wait, Hawk sucks. Outlaw, you're in the game, man. All right. So we'll throw our Raven here. We'll throw our Jump Dude here. And this guy can go here. Yeah, we're totally going to have to reorganize this because these guys are not in the right crews at all. In fact, actually, let's go ahead and do that. All right, we're still 20 tons light, but we need to capture some supply trucks. Should be fine. This guy's going to be on his own, but he is jump capable, I think. Yeah, all right, it's going to be fine. Let's do it. We haven't failed a mission yet. We aren't going to fail this one. Okay, so first things first, let's try and rendezvous our guys together here. So I'm pretty sure this guy here can just straight up jump right over there. Boom. All right. Safety in numbers. So these guys are all jump capable, I believe. Can they jump? Where are these guys? Yeah, jump capable commando. All right, you guys are all over here. Then we have
heads up, I got a new contact.
These guys. We're gonna do that. All right, groups 1, 2, and 3. Bingo. Let's go exploring and find some. What are we looking for? We're looking for vehicles to capture, supply trucks. All right, we also have a Raven that's kind of protecting us. Well, that's good. We've got a new contact. All right, I've also equipped some clan sensors onto some of my guys. So, oh, hello. All right, Commando, you asked for it, dude. You got one-shotted. Why would you run into the middle of battle? Oh my god, those guys go down like nothing. Okay, that is no crew. So we'll just go ahead and take all these guys out. Boom, boom.
Incoming fire.
I guess we'll take out the crew barracks to stop this last guy. I should have taken out the crew barracks first. That would have stopped all these guys from actually powering up. Anyway. That guy, he's got no crew and no crew coming. Nobody's coming to help him. Alright, continuing to search for supply trucks. Seeing what we can find. This mission is interesting because it gives you absolutely no idea where to go. Oh man, there's enemies everywhere though. I just did a sensor probe there. Ooh, hello. Oh, that guy's just straight up dead. Took 2 seconds. Capture that.
Outlaw here, vehicle capture.
Take this guy down. Kaboom.
Yes, bits of mech everywhere.
And that guy.
This shuttle hit them off.
Kaboom. Capture. No. Nope. Ah.
Secondary objective.
Fuck. I accidentally destroyed the vehicle. Okay, whatever. We're just gonna capture 4 trucks. That actually really sucks. After you've taken a truck, why can you target it? My guys targeted one of the trucks they were supposed to try and capture. That's really annoying. Alright, well. We only need to capture 1 or 2 more trucks and we win, so. I guess let's just run over here real quick. We're all just running in one big crew. Yeah, it's kind of an interesting level. It gives you, like, absolutely no direction of where to go. But, yeah, those guys totally missed.
Here. I don't think these guys like me.
From this
here.
Way.
Gunman here. Vehicle
trapped. Mission
capture.
Mission successful.
Succeeded. Well, that was pretty easy. You know what? For the amount of time, it took me to load up all my mechs, I might as well have just like only brought 4. I didn't need. Like, I had, like, different mechs, and, like, some guys were equipped with, like, jump packs and stuff. What a waste of time that was. This mission was so easy. Now we're into 425 tons. Capture the re-education camp. Escort the freed prisoners to base. Protect base HQ. Now we're going to liberate a re-education camp where loyal industry warriors are being held. Reports of patrols that might locate the field base. Before you're able to return to it, protect the HQ building. Okay, so we need to defend the building, which I actually will do this time, and escort the free prisoners to the base. All right, easy enough. Now I get to scrap every single one of these mechs and rebuild my heavies. This is gonna take a while. But the thing that takes a while in this game, honestly, and I'm not complaining, actually, because I do kind of like this loadout. You know, building the loadout so meticulously is kind of fun. But it is kind of annoying how there's no, like, all I want is a button to, like, strip a mech of its parts instantly and put it in storage. Because look at this, I have to, like, manually strip apart every single one of these mechs. Or, like, if I put a mech into storage, all its parts should become just generally available. But I'm pretty sure that doesn't happen. Maybe it does, and I'm an idiot. But this is, you know, a lot of clicking here. For one mission! We set all this stuff up for one mission. Okay, well, first things first, you know we're rebuilding this beast of an Atlas. Jeez, that is an insanely powerful loadout. That is ridiculous. Okay, next we have our Hunchback 2Cs that we're gonna deck out. I recall that each had two PPCs. Well, we managed to fit three PPCs on this bad boy. All right, we're like 125 tons under the capacity, so we probably should take another mech or two. So, why don't we just throw together an awesome real quick? We'll actually throw some ER PPCs on him, honestly, because we're out of normal PPCs. And we'll give him ER lasers. It's actually a decent loadout, to be totally honest.
This is Hitman.
And we'll throw
Outlaw,
Outlaw in there. I kind of want to train Outlaw up. I feel like he could be a good addition to the team. All right, I don't know. We're like 45 tons under limit. I feel like we're probably fine. You know what we could do, though, is see if there's a vehicle that we like. Like, we honestly could just take a refit truck. 35 tons. That might be fine. Or we could take a mine layer. Let's take a refit truck, because we haven't seen one of those yet, even though, you know, really, not like we really need one, but we'll leave it at our base so it can, like, repair our guys. There we go. So the refit truck is capable of, like, doing repairs, which is pretty cool. This will be the defensive team. These big, heavy lugs. And in fact, refit team, you're going to be your own squad. And, okay, you guys are on defense. This is the A team that's on offense, actually. How about we mix it up? Well, first we'll send the heavies in, the assaults. The assaults will clear the way a little bit, and then once the way is kind of clear, then we'll send in the lighter mechs. That way we're sharing the duties, and it's not like these guys have to do everything themselves. So, and we'll send group one. Then group one, like, way over there. Okay, this is, like, actually a big, elaborate, kind of area. Okay, I changed my mind. You guys go back. Alright, those guys are going back to defend. Meanwhile, the A-team is off to kill. Here we go, killing again. So they are only 50-ton mechs, but I feel like they're punching above their weight class. Like, I feel like they definitely have enough firepower to take on heavy or even assault mechs. And then definitely my assault mechs are capable of just destroying anything, so they'll be fine. I really could just leave the Atlas and bring the Awesome to with me if I wanted, but I don't know if it's really necessary. We're going to try to get away with not doing it. All right, off you guys go. This is an interesting mission because you're going to have to, like, run across the whole battlefield here. Where are you guys going? Here, everyone gather together. Now off you go. So escort the freed prisoners. Oh, well, we only have 13 minutes to capture this base, too, actually. Capture the re-education. Alright, this is why, precisely why, oops, we left the Atlas to protect. Kaboom! Well, that guy's just gonna straight up go down. He's not gonna last. Kaboom! Oh, here we go. Boom! Hey, they're going for the repair vehicle. There we go. I feel like it's fun to, like, cripple the enemy mech. See, like, that guy, he's suffered so much damage. here we go. Alright, now it's your guys' turn to get into the fray. The fracas. That guy's ejected. I mean, we are just killing a bunch of light mechs, so we shouldn't pat ourselves in the back too much. But those guys just went down like crazy. So now the cool thing is this guy can come over here and can repair these guys and like refill their ammo. Which is pretty cool. Alright, who are you? Who dares fight me? A couple of tanks.
I'm on it, sir.
Kaboom, kaboom, kaboom. One less enemy crawler. Easily done. Oh, and that guy doesn't even need repairs. This guy is all energy weapons. He doesn't need refills or anything. Okay, how much time we got left here? We're working with 11 minutes. Wow, that's actually like by the time we get over there. Go. Okay, they are moving. Sometimes I find that when you give commands to guys in this game, they like kind of ignore your orders and just don't do anything. Oh, that guy just ejected before my weapons even hit. He was like, forget it! I'm out! I'm out, I don't want to quarrel with you, bro. There. Okay, they know where they're going. Should I climb up this mountain and get a better vantage point? I think so. Even though I have slow mechs. We're rapidly running out of time. 10 minutes left! 10 minutes left. I think we got time. Took 5 minutes to run across the whole map here. I think we got time. Keep running though, guys. Don't stop running. They're like going into like a light, I don't know what you call it. Not a jog, but okay. I see the base. We need to run over there. Okay, so going up that hill just actually did waste some time. Not gonna lie. Nobody else wants to attack this base. They saw what happened to the first crew and they were like, forget it. We're not getting involved in that mess. You want us to take on a heavily armed Atlas and awesome.
Beast here, heads up, I've got a new contact.
That ain't happening. Ooh, a Rommel tank.
They're coming after me.
How will I defeat it? Alright, they actually have some forces to defend. Let's back up so their turrets actually can't get a good shot at us. And then let's let them have it. Call in a small strike as well. 3, 2, 1. Kaboom! Kaboom! This guy down. This guy down. Take this thing down.
Hunter here. I'm taking fire.
Take this thing down.
This is Hunter. Gap one.
Take you down.
Enemy crawler.
All right. Anyone else hanging around? Anyone else re-educating our glorious inner sphere soldiers? Re-education center just has like a really negative connotation. Like nobody goes to a re-education camp voluntarily. It's not like a summer camp or something. It just sounds objectively bad. Okay, before I capture the re-education camp though, I definitely want those turrets under my control. And I want these resources. Alright. Oh no, this thing is gunning it. APC, wait for us! APC! We don't have mechs that are fast enough to like keep pace with this thing. Oh no, it's gonna outrun us. This is actually a little intense. We definitely have to run as fast as we can to stay up, keep up with this thing. Oh my god, look at it go! Look at it go. Oh, hello. You guys are coming to attack, are you? Well, we're gonna go guard there. I see. Oh god, the PPC is getting away from our guys. There's a bunch of ravens. Interesting. Alright, I don't know what these things are. Really tiny. A series of very tiny vehicles. The enemy is like, you know what? If we just send a whole bunch of really small vehicles, maybe that'll work. It's like the stupidest plan ever. Oh, I definitely don't like the look of that thing, though. Okay, we definitely are gonna have to kill that thing.
This is counted.
Reporting
vehicle destroyed.
So, F2.
Executing your order.
We want to kill that thing.
Falcon here. Incoming fire.
Oh, God.
Hunter, taking fire. Incoming.
Took it out, sir.
Something got us good.
Say adios.
Counted here. Reporting
I think we destroyed it, but something got us good.
Hunter here. Got one. I'm on it, sir.
Okay. This is call a strike here, because these things are so slow. Oh no! He's attacking! He's attacking the APC! No! We don't have any way of defending this. No! Oh my god, I feel like we're gonna lose this mission. I feel like we're totally gonna lose this mission. Because this APC just like ran away from all of our dudes. Oh, this is so bad. Defend yourself. If the maybe the APC is capable of defending itself.
I'm getting shot at.
I don't know. I have a feeling we're gonna lose like right near the end here.
Proceeding as ordered.
Oh my god. Where are the heavy mechs? Run, APC, run! Defend yourself! Here comes the Atlas and the Awesome! Where are you, dudes? Why isn't this guy moving? Why did he decide that now's a good time to not move? Oh, come on, dude. Where are you guys? Open fire! Yeah! Oh, you defended it! You sweet angels! You sweet angels!
I'm under attack.
Okay. I think we got it.
I'm on it, sir. Wait here.
Oh my god. We somehow made it. If this APC gets killed by this tank, I'm gonna be so mad. I think the tank is just obsessed with killing that turret, though. Can't believe we made it. That was insane. That was a huge screw up on my part.
Mission objective complete.
We succeeded! Oh my god! Oh my god, did you see the ravens? They totally ambushed us. That is the sturdiest APC I've ever seen. It stood up to like a good 30 seconds to a minute of persistent raven fire. That APC is like the MVP. Hey, we got some jump-capable ravens and cougars. It's actually kind of cool. I still want to get away from using light mechs and get into heavy mechs. 480 tons, no light mechs this time. Protect the base, protect the sensors, protect the north turret power, and the south. Ooh, this is going to be a good one. This is base defense. Spotted a clan force approaching a bondsman base we recently captured. The officer has been notified. Upon your arrival, you'll be placed in command of the Allied base, which includes at least one mine layer. Satellite observation showed the enemy will arrive in waves. There are two repair bays. Not gonna need them. Trust me, my guys are battle-hardened beasts. They will crush anything you throw at us. The only reason my guys are damaged right now is because the enemy got a few cheap shots off with some artillery. They didn't damage us through actual ability. Far from it. Okay, I'm just going to hold on to these jump-capable Oolers. Just because in case we do have some other mission that needs, a fast response team. I like having jump-capable light mechs. It's actually fairly handy. Ooler W, that's going to get sold. This Ooler W, that's going to get sold. We have a couple of Cougars here that we will... check out. I like Cougars. I think they might be my favorite light mech, as it turns out. I can't 100% say why. But man, we have so many mechs at this point. Okay, I'm gonna hold on to jump-capable Ravens too, but I'm not gonna bother unequipping stuff from them. Or this. This has a clan LRM pack that we want. Okay. There we go. Let's go into purchasing and dump these Oolers that we don't need. Boom, boom. And, man, we have so many mechs, it's crazy. Let's see if we can buy any PPCs. Buy one. Maybe we should start buying ER PPCs too, because it actually, you know what, maybe I'm being sold a little bit on them. It's actually not a terrible thing to lose one LRM pack to have a PPC. It actually, I think, maybe is worth it in the end. Anyway, I think our crew, currently this crew is going into combat. We definitely know that. So we got, you know, force two here. We have force one. And let's see how much tonnage we have left to play with. We have 100 tons. That smells to me like an Atlas. Why put in lighter mechs when you can just go for the very best of the best? The heaviest weapon. You do not have enough points. Oh no, I don't have enough money? That's a shame. I mean, I guess I could sell some of these. Okay, let's sell this. And this. How much money do I need? I need like 30,000. Okay, I have tons of Oolers. Let's sell this one. Let's sell this one. Okay, how many Cougars do I have? I could do a full squad of armored Cougars. Or one Cougar W. Okay, we're gonna sell this. We have so many Ravens too. Just thinking here. Yeah, I don't need jump capable Ravens in addition to jump capable Oolers and Ubers. These Centurions, I don't know if they're ever going to get used again. Oh, we have enough money. Okay, whatever. Let's go with another Atlas. Boom. We are now poor. We have spent all of our money on the most powerful mechs that money can buy. We'll dump all this stuff. Dump, dump, dump. Oh, you know what? I could have actually sold a bunch of components. Like if, like, I have like 13 pulse lasers here. Never gonna use any of those. SRM packs. Might as well just sell like all of them. What else do we have? Planned streak SRM packs. Never gonna use those. What else can we sell? We can sell some autocannons. I don't like those. I like to have at least one of every weapon just in case I want to use it, but like, who are we kidding? Never gonna use most of the stuff. All right, we now have 36,000. I feel less bad about spending all our money on the basic Atlas. All right, PPC, of course. ER PPCs, of course. ER lasers, and some LRM packs. We can do clan LRM packs, in fact. Let's see if we can, make this work. Clan LRM, clan LRM, clan LRM. Wow. This has 3 PPCs, 5 LRM packs, 3 ER lasers. It has a bit less punch, to be honest, than a bit less punch than our other Atlas, but still pretty beastly. I mean, this guy has 4 P. You're not beating this guy. My God. All right. He's deadly enough. And we'll throw in...
This is Scarab.
You can go in, buddy. You can get trained up. Boom, boom, boom. All right. 480 tons of pure mech. So, this will be the main combat force that has maneuverability, and this will be sort of like the defense force. That's basically my thinking going into this. F1 and F2. All right. Into combat we go. And we have Pegasuses, which are going to do nothing, to be honest. So you guys can be group 3. Be group 4.
New leader selected.
All right. You run over here. I have no idea what direction the enemies are going to come from. So my plan is to just mine everything. We'll just mine these entrances over here. This. There you go. Boom, kaboom. Oh, they're coming from like the east, I guess. Okay, well, that is not the direction that we want to mine then, I guess. How are they planning to get in over here? Hard to even tell. Yeah, like, the only gate is way over here. I don't know. This is one of those missions, I feel, where you basically need to play it once and see how the enemy behaves, and then you'll know, like, where to mine. But honestly, I'm not convinced we're really going to need the mining, so... you know, we'll just... Everyone congregate over here, let's see what the enemy does, and... First squad to get over here, we will attack. You guys go over here. It looks like these guys are going to be the first ones to the party. Actually, by a long shot, so... Get over here. Mine layer. I don't know, just keep mining the entrance. If they do happen to get in the base...
I have a new contact on my screen.
Where are you? Welcome to the party!
Very good, sir.
This is Wayne. My sensors have a new contact.
I almost want to, like, destroy my own wall to, like, give them an entrance so I can shoot at them. Are they jump capable? Sort of. I guess they're not so jump capable when you just obliterate them. Okay, you run away. They're totally gonna come- they're totally gonna fall for this gate thing. They're gonna get mined. If they even make it that far.
Yes, sir.
Kaboom! Eat a whole bunch of missiles! Wow, I don't even think we took a lick of damage there. Alright, so that was easy-ish. I'm going to re-maneuver my guys down here, because I know that there was a another group of guys. Yeah, here they are. They might also be jump capable. We shall see. I feel like if I had a smaller base, this would be way easier. I could just linger outside the base and crush everyone who came near, but I guess that's the point. You're supposed to have some trouble with maneuvering here. I wonder what happened if they jumped over the wall, captured my turrets, and then I killed them. Could I capture it back? I've never actually seen enemies capture buildings or anything in this game.
This is the beast. Uh-oh. New contact.
Where are they? Oh, here they come.
Very good, sir. Proceeding as ordered.
Oh, they're trying to destroy my turrets. I honestly feel like this would have been a good mission to just select tons of LRMs because you're firing over walls, so it's like my PPCs are kind of useless at the moment. Kaboom!
Yes, sir.
Incoming fire.
But, I mean, I do have an abundance of LRMs compared to an average mech, so...
Sorry, I can't do that.
We're gonna totally go ahead and obliterate these guys. 2, 1. Kaboom! That's how you use artillery! They're trying to destroy the wall.
Very good, sir.
Oh, guys are actually getting in over here. But we got mines. So I'm gonna bring back the quick... rapid response force. The main guys will just stay over here.
Executing your order.
Man, they can't even destroy a wall. I feel bad. I kind of feel bad for them. I kind of want them to destroy the wall, though, because then, like, I could unleash my fury. But since they can't even destroy the wall, I can't even use my most powerful weapons. My PPCs are totally useless on this level. I feel so impotent.
This is Garib. Enemy mech destroyed.
Executing your order.
I'm having to kill them purely with the power of LRMs. Those guys just don't even know what to do. My turrets are totally taking care of them. Boom. I could be repairing my units and, like, refilling their ammo, but I almost feel like they don't even need it. Let's kill that guy. Alright. And what's going on over here?
Here.
These guys still can't get in.
As ordered, sir.
It's such a weird standoff. They can't get in, and I can't actually do enough damage to them to make it matter. Okay, I'm gonna bring back my other crew. They sent, like, 10 mechs, and they can't even get in the base. That is embarrassing.
Acknowledged.
That is really embarrassing.
Another one for the kill board.
I mean, I guess I did use artillery and stuff on them, but, like, that's crazy. And out of all that, I got barely any salvage. There you go. Kaboom! I guess let's go ahead and repair our mechs. Where's that repair bay? There it is. Alright, let's go ahead and refill our ammos. We don't really need to repair our mechs so much as we need to refill ammo. Is there a specific amount of time we need to defend our base for? Guess not. I guess it's just until the job is done. You protect until we say that you're done protecting. Alright, one at a time, hunchbacks. These are the hunchiest bunch of hunchbacks that ever hunched.
Got it, sir.
And believe me, I know what I'm talking about.
This is Link. There's no way through here.
Doesn't hunch mean like to hook up? Isn't that like a millennial club term? Are these sex robots? Oh man, I've been playing so much Battletech, my brain is rotting. These are sex robots.
I'm on it, sir.
Oh, this is so tedious. Oh, that guy doesn't need to repair. This guy has no ammo. Which is fitting, even though I customized him. Traditionally, the Awesome is a purely energy-based mech. I feel like if the PPCs had indirect fire, I would just throw on PPCs. The only reason that LRMs are good is because they kind of ignore line of sight, so they can fire over walls and stuff. So as you saw, as you're seeing in this engagement, it's actually quite, I wouldn't say vital, but it's very handy to have LRMs. If I didn't have LRMs, there would be no way for me to have defended my base against those guys. I would have had to actually create a hole in my own wall in order to fight them. And you don't want to intentionally let the enemies in your base if you can avoid it. This mine layer, by the way, has done absolutely nothing. Is there anything over here? Why is there something blinking over here? I don't know what that's about. I don't know what these guys are shooting at either. Alright, everyone over here. They seem to be coming somewhere over here. Oh, they're coming for the gate. I see. Everybody, get over here! Defend the gate! They've destroyed the sensor. I could launch a sensor probe if I wanted to see where those guys are, but I feel like I'm saving it. I'm not quite ready to need it yet. But I am ready to use an airstrike if I need to. Or feel like it if I want to. Alright. Hunchbacks.
Acknowledged.
Prepare to meet your maker. And we'll go ahead and do an airstrike right around there. Kaboom! Oh, I'm actually opening the gate to let them in. That was unintentional, but you know what? Probably I'll just kill them faster, so whatever. Yeah, come on in, the gate's open, boys! They're like, hey, they're opening the gate! And they like run in front of the gate, they're like, oh my god! There's just like some like fully decked out atlases and stuff. You know what? Whatever, we're engaging them. We have this crazy, oh, hello. They have LRMs, they got smart on us.
Very good, sir.
Kaboom!
Very good, sir.
See, this is that's actually brilliant of the enemy, because then if I'm like trying to like stay hidden in my base, it like totally doesn't work. But unluckily for them, you picked the wrong dudes to mess with. Oh, look at all these PPCs! Welcome to PPC country, population U! Damn. Look at the health bars of my guys. I don't think they took hardly any damage. We just annihilated them. Hardcore. Damn, our guys are elite and veterans. It's so funny to like play this game in contrast to the Crescent Hawks games, which are notoriously so hard. We got two catapults out of that, which is pretty sweet. I mean, I would have wanted those several missions ago. I feel like now that we're fielding atlases and stuff, I'm kind of moved beyond catapults, but like, look, this guy needs a bit of repair. Look at this guy. This is how much damage he took. We might as well repair that. We don't want this guy going into combat damaged. And nobody, two of my mechs took damage. The rest are untouched. That enemy force was completely ineffective. That is hilarious. Ooh, another ER laser. I will take that. So I guess when you get down to it, my mechs are PPCs, ER lasers, clan ER lasers, and LRM racks, and that's basically all I use. I don't know, I hope that's not boring or whatever, but it's like, I make no apologies about not changing that strategy, because it is an awesome strategy. I'm gonna pull these LRM racks off of these catapults, even though really there's no point to it. I'm probably just gonna sell these catapults, to be honest, but I don't know, we'll see. I'm definitely gonna dump this Uller, and I'm gonna dump these hunchbacks. We have clan variant hunchbacks. We don't need inner sphere rash. I only use clan mechs and atlases in my army. All right, we have tons of money, tons of cash, 450 tons. Yes, please destroy the administration building. That is when you've just had it with HR and you're like, we are done. We are done. This is, I think, also the last mission of this particular operation. So destroy the administration building, get our forces to the extraction point, capture the sensor control. We can do all three. The culmination of phase three of our invasion is upon us. Your primary objective is to destroy their administration building. As soon as their bureaucracy is in ruins, their will to fight will crumble. Italian intelligence believes that taking control of the local clan center would be invaluable. Power generators for the turrets are located in the southeast. Okay, so if we go over here, so here's our plan. We're kind of swoop this way. And then, wait, what do we want to do? Destroy the administration, and we can kind of go like this. Maybe we want to go here and then down and around. So we'll go to sensors first. So that's our first stop. Okay. So first off, I'm loving the assault force of hunchbacks. This is actually a great team. I don't want to break up that team. Next, we have our double Atlas team. We don't have enough room for this guy. We could alternatively scrap our Atlases, but I just feel like I want to bring my Atlases into combat. I think we will easily deal with whatever we happen to engage in the battlefield with this. What if we did this? We have a bit of extra tonnage. Why don't we just grab two jump-capable light mechs? Let's just grab two Uhlers. Two jump-capable Uhlers. And what we will do, sort of deck them out in the standard loadout of PPCs and ER lasers and stuff. And we'll just have these guys in case we need to infiltrate a base, basically. So, in fact, you know what? I'm not even going to put ER PPCs on them because they're not even supposed to get in fights. I'm just going to throw a couple of lasers on them, and then they're going all with LRM packs from there. Okay, these guys aren't even fully equipped for the payload, but honestly, I feel like I just don't care.
This is Gunman.
Because these guys are basically this is not even the B team, it's the C team. These guys are basically just here to jump into bases if we need them. So this is our final mission. So we're going to go three, loop back around.
Commencing deployment.
And if we need our jumpies to jump into places, they will. Otherwise, these guys are just here for the ride. They're not even here to actually really fight. So that's the backup of the backup squad. The main force, an Atlas and Awesome, and four hunchbacks coming to crush it. Coming to annihilate absolutely anything that they identify as possibly hostile. They'll even kill things that are neutral. That's hostile enough. Anything that is not for us is against us. Kill that thing. Ooh, we got a couple of catapults. So, the fight begins already, eh? Alright, here we go. Kaboom!
I am under attack.
I just want to see these things like just drop like pancakes. Mechs get bigger, but the battles get easier. Alright, that catapult picked off more than he could chew. Alright, he's done. Oh, we're actually getting more contacts. Hey, what's going on? Are you attacking my Uhlers? I guess the Uhlers will defend themselves. They're not gonna just totally ignore combat. They can fight a single truck, though, that's fine. Boom, boom. Oh, this is the perfect space for the Oolers to try to engage. So these guys are going to draw all the fire. And the Oolers are going to come up here. And they're just going to jump their way in.
Beast here. Uh-oh.
Where are they? Jump! And they're going to jump their way in over here. And... boom. Okay. Hopefully these Oolers can not die. they can't capture anything until this catapult goes down. Oh man. This is the first intense fight we've had this entire video, I think. They're just standing there, taking it. Okay, quickly, capture the turrets. Yes. And capture this. Okay, I have a feeling one of these Oolers lost some weapons. Let's take a look. Hopefully he didn't lose anything too important. Data, payload. Oh no, he's just taking a crap ton of damage. Alright, so that he should be able to heal up.
Beast here. I can't find a way through here.
Oh, capture the gate controls.
I've got it.
Repair.
Gunman here. Building capture.
There we go.
Refit complete.
Oh yeah, Mystique. Wow. I can't believe so that was a really reckless strategy. I just jumped in the base willy-nilly. Every turret around me was firing on me. I can't believe these Oolers actually survived. But they did precisely what I needed them to do. They jumped into a high octane environment and they took control. That's what I needed. All right, now we'll take a bit of time and heal up our whole crew in the mech repair bays here. It'll be like we're brand new again. So I think this entire playthrough so far, this is the third video. I think the entire playthrough so far, we have only lost one mech, and he died when we accidentally walked on a train that we had already crashed. We walked on the cars because I thought that could destroy them, and we blew ourselves up. So our only damage, our only actual loss in this game was self-inflicted to some degree. So we should also capture that. Oh, look at all the enemies. We now know exactly where everyone is and what they plan on doing. Like, who are these guys? Ooh, three Jaeger mechs. And some bridge controls. Interesting. Alright. Who else needs to be repaired? Come down here. Do you need? Yeah. So basically, everyone just needed a refill of ammo. That's all they needed. This guy's like sauntering over. You know what? If I was a mech pilot, I would saunter too. Being a mech pilot's badass. My mech would have like a sassy swagger as he walked around the battlefield. Especially if I was in an Atlas. You know why? Because nobody can say anything. If you're in an Atlas, and they would just infuriate the enemy to see you walking around with a sassy walk. They'd be like, that effing Atlas is at it again. He's taunting us. And it would make them, you know, go on tilt, let their guard down, and then before you know it, I'm crushing them with six PPCs right to their face. Because that's how Atlases do. And I wish I knew what those were. Are those mechs or vehicles? I'll send my Oolers to engage them if they're just vehicles, but I'm kind of afraid. Alright, you guys go over here.
Take these
guys down. Kaboom, kaboom. He's already at half health. And you come running over this way. Oh, is he trying to destroy the bridge?
Yes.
You jerk. Destroy this guy before he can finish the job.
Outlaw here. I'm taking enemy fire.
Kaboom. Alright. I want to see what's down here. I just need to know. I'm gonna have my Oolers do the scouting. If it's danger, I'll send my main crew. If it's just like a couple of vehicles, I'll let the Oolers take care of it. Oolers. Good European name here. That is mechs. That is a bunch of mechs.
I'm taking fire.
Alright, that's a good fight. I'm looking forward to that fight. Meantime, Oolers, you did your job. In fact, don't go too far. Anything, you could lure the enemy towards us. Oh yeah, they're like, hey, chase down those light mechs. Oh my god! Oh, it's a trap! We got trapped, y'all! We got punked! Those are not light mechs! Those are insane, heavy assault mechs. We've been hunched! We hunched them good. I feel like hunching is like squanching. It can mean whatever you want. Although I think squanching was inherently dirty in Rick and Morty, so whatever. But I'm gonna use it anyway. I was gonna send my Oolers up to get repaired, but like honestly, they took like what, 3 laser hits? They're fine. Can't baby these mechs forever. These mechs gotta grow up someday.
That'll take care of him.
Then we're gonna just jump in here. And we'll jump in here. Southern turret control. We will definitely take that out.
Yes,
and we will control the gates.
Gunman here. Building capture.
This southern turret control, is this going to destroy the turrets that I've already captured? I guess it doesn't matter, but whatever, we'll destroy it anyway. Also, get away from those gas canisters. Oh, there's a mech repair bay here. They keep wanting you to repair your mechs. I guess we'll somewhat refill our ammo. This feels like a total waste of time. I don't know, I'll refill the ammo of just a couple of these mechs while we're here. These guys, the slower guys, are not going to repair. What are these guys doing? They're running along the edge of the map? I don't even understand. Okay, stop wasting ammo. What is happening here? These guys took a very convoluted path. Oh my god, dude, stop firing. Just get out of here. Leave. Alright, we're done with the refits. There's no way we're gonna run out of ammo. If we do, whatever. We have enough PPCs to crush whatever happens to try to engage us. What are you doing? Stop taking that path. They're so confused. Take this path here. I think the pathfinding in this game is actually not very good. I've seen mechs just stop walking because they bump into another mech. Mechs will stop walking when you change command groups. They have trouble getting out of bases and stuff like, why is this guy stopped? Or did I tell him to only go there? I forget. I don't know. Maybe I only told him to go there. Whatever. So I can't tell if these turrets have no power or not. I don't know if I knocked out their power. We're salvaging a ton of catapults though, which is kind of cool. Again, not the mechs that I want anymore, but I did want them at some point, so it was kind of cool, I guess. Anyway, off to the final leg of this journey, of this battle. Here. Resources to capture. Don't mind if I do. You capture that, you capture that. See if there's anything else cool to get around here. Fuel depot. There's some walls over here. Might indicate something.
Reporting new contact.
Nothing, 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 nothing. Okay. Oh god, if the enemy attacked right now in those fuel tanks, I would be obliterated.
Beast here. Uh-oh. New contact.
Okay. I'm gonna let the Oolers take care of that.
Gunman here. Vehicle.
And this.
I've got it.
Actually, it's nice having a couple of light mechs to sort of, like, clean up the stragglers. So I can have my assault class mechs take on assault class problems.
I've got it.
Rather than wasting their time fighting, like, a truck. A truck is just about as big a threat as you want a light mech handling.
Okay.
I'm gonna bring my Oolers over here in case I need to jump this wall.
One less enemy crawler.
Okay, everybody run. Get in here. Take control of the gates.
Reporting building secure.
Okay, everyone keep going. Don't just stand there in the doorway, please.
There's no way through here.
I can't get through here.
And capture.
Outlaw here. Reporting building secure.
Alright.
Got it, sir. Yes, sir.
One and two. Combat! Mech combat. Let's zoom in for this. We can, like, see these guys get destroyed in high resolution. Kaboom! Oh, you're sending more and more, eh? Here, how about this? Have an airstrike.
I'm getting shot at. Link here, that takes care of him.
Let's spray this guy. Kaboom!
I'll do what I can.
I like how they saw that the airstrike was coming and they just stood there. They like had very little interest or ability in running away or dodging or anything like that. This looks like a nice, rich, established place to have your HR department. Your administrative building. Boy, the administrators are really highly regarded in the BattleTech universe. They live in palaces. This is where you come to get your paychecks. In the clan universe. That's funny. Alright, there's very little threat left on the battlefield. Despite, like, the turrets and stuff attacking us, like, we're really not taking very much damage. I know we could end the level, but honestly, I want to, get your forces to the extraction point. Okay, I guess there's the extraction point. I want to kill these guys. I know there's guys over there.
Got it, sir.
Go ahead and capture this. You, go ahead. Capture this thing up here. Boom.
Reporting building capture.
Oh yeah, there's a catapult. You want some action, bud? I'll give you some action. He was guarding a bridge and then on the other side, behind him, an enemy force just took over the bridge. That's when you know you failed in your duty. When you're guarding a castle and you turn around and it's flying the enemy's flag and you're like, oh, somebody actually took control of that castle, eh? I failed.
I'll do what I can.
I think he's desperately trying to destroy the bridge.
Not gonna destroy it in time, pal. I got you.
He's like backing up cautiously. He's actually surviving a lot longer than I thought he would, to be honest. With all the mechs that I've got, I am shocked that he lived for as long as he did. There's one other contact here. I wonder if it's like a huge, you know, like Mad Cat or something. You know what's interesting? Mad Cats are like the most iconic BattleTech clan mech in the universe. We're halfway through the game. We've only seen one. And I'm still sad that we weren't able to salvage it. But I don't know. Maybe this will be a Mad Cat and we can finally salvage a Mad Cat. I would take Mad Cat cats over Hunchbacks. That would be the sort of upgrade. If I got a team of Mad Cats, I would give up my Hunchbacks. Go ahead and capture this. Oh, speak of the devil! Alright, Mad Cats.
You're getting salvaged, buddy.
Just go down peacefully, man. Just go down peacefully. Oh, look, there's a whole little final battle here. Are you guys trying to stop me? Well, it's not gonna work. In fact, just go into full-on melee fracas mode. Everyone fight, even the Oolers, even the garbage mechs. Did I get a Mad Cat? No, I did not. Son of a bitch. I'm never gonna get my Mad Cats. I'm so sad.
That takes care of him.
They've actually damaged Lynx. I'm shocked. Down he goes. Boom. Alright, I'm pretty sure the rest of the battlefield is crushed. And I can't believe we didn't get... Look, we have so many mechs that we've salvaged. Can't get a single Mad Cat. Can't catch a break. Alright, well that was a pretty epic battle though, I will say. Even though we didn't get what we wanted, that was a pretty epic battle. You know what, we're gonna start fighting more and more Mad Cats. We will get some. The game's just playing very coy with us. Apparently. I mean, they're starting to give us tons of catapults. Eventually, the map will be littered with Mad Cats, too. Oh, yeah. 32 enemies destroyed. Zero of us. Well, this is... And we even got a commendation for low drop weight. So, I will take that as well. All right. Well, we have successfully beat the third operation of the main campaign of MechCommander here. That was the Vanguard operation. We are now in the, I think this is now the fourth operation. Yeah, four. And there are only five operations. So in our next video, we will be tackling Operation Linchpin, which is right before the final operation, Operation Cutthroat, which is where the real battles begin. So we got two more videos to run through MechCommander here. Oh my god, drop limit 15 tons. What is that about? I guess we're going to find out in the next video. If you have been enjoying the playthrough here of MechCommander, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe and all that jazz. But anyway, until next time, my friends, I hope you have been enjoying yourselves. And until we meet again, remember, no guts, no galaxy. Alrighty, guys. Peace.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because